I heard in my heart pounded. My lips quivered at the sound. Decay crept into my bones and my legs trembled. Yet I will wait patiently for the day of calamity to come on the nation, invading us. I will wait patiently, though the fig tree does not bud, and there are no grapes on the vines, though the olive crop fails, and the fields produce no food, though there are no sheep in the in the Lord. I will be joyful in God my Savior, yet I will rejoice in the Lord. I will be joyful in God my Savior, the sovereign Lord is my strength. He makes my feet like the feet of a deer. The sovereign Lord is my strength. He enables me to go on the heights. The sovereign Lord is my strength. He makes my feet like the feet of a deer. The sovereign Lord is my strength. He enables me. He enables me. He enables me. He enables me.
Praise the Lord. This is the voice of Prophetess Maxine Hopkins coming your way on a Thursday morning, well, afternoon rather. Just giving God the praise this morning. The Lord gave me a word this morning at 4:59 a.m. I woke up and he turned me to the book of Habakkuk, and he landed my eyes on the prayer of Habakkuk, how Habakkuk was praying to God and longing for, you know, the deeds of God, how he made them known to the people of old. And he said in verse 1, renew them in our day. He wanted God to renew his deeds in our day, and that's something that, you know, we need even in this day and time, is for God to renew his deeds in this day and even in 2012. So I began to just read over the prayer, and the Lord just began to speak to me in the 16th chapter of the third, I'm sorry, the 16th verse of the third chapter of Habakkuk, and I'm going to read that in your hearing. It says, I heard and my heart pounded. My lips quivered at the sound. Decay crept into my bones, and my legs trembled. Yet I will wait patiently for the day of calamity to come on the nation invading us. Though the fig tree does not bud, and there are no grapes on the vines, though the olive crop fail, and the fields produce no food, though there are no sheep in the pen, and no cattle in the stalls, yet I will rejoice in the Lord. I will be joyful in God my Savior. The sovereign Lord is my strength. He makes my feet like the feet of a deer. He enables me to go on the heights. And I just praise God for the reading of that word, because the Lord began to speak to me out of this word this morning, and he was letting me know that we must begin to guard our hearts, because our hearts are being invaded. And he let me know that he said, I heard and my heart pounded. And a lot of times we hear things and our heart begins to pound. The Lord let me know that our hearing is connected to our heart. Our hearing is connected to our heart. Our ears are connected to our heart. What we hear is connected to what we feel. What we hear is connected to what we feel. And for a long time, if you don't know that your ears are connected to your heart, you're letting in things and your heart is being consumed and overwhelmed and you're being invaded. And you don't know, by nations of people, nations of things, the enemy. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. And it says, I heard and my heart pounded. I heard and my heart pounded. I just began to meditate on that. And the Lord instructed me to even put an inspirational piece out on Facebook about it, you know, because I was like, Lord, you're really saying something here, and help me to get what you're really saying. And so I just want to encourage your heart this morning that if you've heard, or maybe you are hearing something either today, whatever days, that has caused your heart to pound, I want you to know the Lord is sending a word today and telling you to let not your heart be troubled. We have a, we have some authority over our heart, because he's saying, let not your heart be troubled. That means you can permit it to be troubled, or you cannot permit it to be troubled. And it says, you believe in God, believe also in me. And this passage is coming from John 14. And it says, our hearts are connected to our ears. What we hear can affect us negatively or positively. It can affect us negatively or positively. It can either move us towards faith or towards fear. And the Bible says, the day that you hear my voice, harden not your heart. So here we have an example of how hearing can cause us to harden our hearts. It depends on what we hear, and it depends on if our spirits are right to receive it. It depends, because it says, the day you hear my voice, harden not your heart. Okay, so it may be a day where, you know, the Lord may be speaking to you. If you don't want to hear that and you're not in the right mind frame, then you have the ability to harden your hearts to the words of God. But if you're in a right frame of mind and your will is to do the will of God, when you hear his voice, you're not going to harden your heart, because he said, my sheep know my voice, and the voice of a stranger they're not going to follow. Hallelujah. If you're a sheep of God, you will not harden your heart to the words of God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. So, amen. Amen. So I'm just reading through here. I just wanted to encourage your heart today to take heed how you hear today. Okay, we need to take heed how we hear. We can hear, but we need to take heed how we hearing. How am I hearing today? Am I hearing by faith, or am I hearing according to the world standards? Am I hearing, because it says faith comes by hearing, and if I'm not hearing by faith, I have no faith. If my ear is not connected to the word of God, then I'm not hearing faith. And if I'm not hearing faith, I'm hearing other voices. The Lord let me know that, you know, he says, I stand to the door and knock. And if you hear me, you open up and let me in, you know. So there are things standing, knocking, and if you're opening the doors of your heart to everything that knocks, praise the Lord, then that is what is invading your heart. It's invading your heart, and then you're beginning to feel overwhelmed, condemned, confused, discombobulated, all of that, but it's not the will of God. You need to make sure that your heart is covered by the door of Jesus. He is the door. He said, I am the door to the sheep. That means can't nobody get to you except Jesus allows them to get to you. He is the door. He's the door of us, and that means that anybody that comes, they got to come through him first to get to me. So long as we are hearing God, and long as we are hearing this word, and our ears connected to the word, then we're connected to the door. We're connected to the door, and if we're connected to the door, then they cannot get to your heart. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. He said, come unto me, all you that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you. My yoke is easy and my burden is light. He said, my yoke is easy and my burden is light. I'm meek and lowly in heart. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Jesus wants to protect your heart. He says, guard your heart, for out of it flows the issues of life. And this passage of scripture in Habakkuk was letting me know the enemy is doing spirit invasions on people. You know, just like they do home invasions. He's doing invasions on people's spirit. He's invading their spirit, and they're hearing, but they're not hearing faith. And if you don't know the word of God, you don't know the word of God, you're not hearing faith. You're hearing a voice that's telling you stuff, and you're thinking that it's God, and it's not God. And we need to be very careful about that, because we're living in the last and evil days. Hallelujah, glory be to God. It says here, I heard and my heart pounded, my lips quivered at the sound. So his lips didn't quiver because Jesus is Lord. Here it was saying that his lips quivered at the sound. And the sound came from what he heard. So a lot of times, if you're hearing something, your heart takes an action. It begins to pound. And then once your heart begins to pound, then your lips begin to quiver. Well, quiver means to tremble. And the Lord began to let me know that we're only supposed to tremble because of him. So anything that causes my lips to tremble have gotten into my worship. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. It's want me to worship it. It wants me to bow down to it. And the Lord said to Satan, I will not bow down. He said, you are to worship the Lord your God, and to him only shall you serve. Because Satan told him, bow down and worship me if you're the Son of God. So a lot of times, even our identities, when our identities in Christ are challenged, that can cause our heart to pound. That can cause our lips to quiver, and the enemy try to make us bow down. Because if you don't know who you are, you don't know who Jesus is, and you don't know that who you are in Christ, then your lips may tremble, and you will begin to say things that is not in line with the faith of Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. We are to be in the faith of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. We're supposed to always give glory to God. So I'm just saying this word today because I promised that I would put it out here on Facebook, you know, just for those who wanted this additional word, you know, because this is something that God is telling us. Hallelujah. Through Habakkuk. Then it says, decay crept into my bones. And I began to think about that. When your lips tremble, that means that you're going to begin to say things that are not the word of God. And when you begin to say things that are not the word of God, decay is coming. Decay, decay, decay. Because the word of God says, there is no condemnation to them who are in Christ Jesus, but who are walking in the spirit and not after the flesh. So when your mouth or your lips start trembling and start saying things that's not according to the word of God, then you get into condemnation. When you get into condemnation, then decay enters. Hallelujah. Decay enters into your bones. Hallelujah. Okay. Thank you, Jesus. Okay. Thank you, Lord. Decay enters into your bones. And when decay enters into your bones, it's still the enemy coming to steal, kill, and destroy. And we're just going to take a quick moment and go over here and look and see what decay means, because I want to give you a very good understanding of that. Now, decay means to become rotten, to decompose and become soft, crumbly, or liquefied, or make something do this. Somebody wants to make you liquefied. They want to make you crumble. So when your lips begin to quiver, you begin to speak to things that's not of faith, because you're not hearing faith, because your ears heard something and your heart began to pound. When your heart began to pound, your lips begin to quiver. When your lips begin to quiver, then your bones, the decay enters into the bones, okay? Because you're no longer worshiping God. You're worshiping what you're hearing. You're worshiping what you're hearing. And he's saying that is beginning to make you liquefied. That's making you crumble. Hallelujah. That's making you crumble. Hallelujah. And when it makes us, it makes you decline in quality or gradually and steadily, or make something, it disintegrates you. It undergoes, disintegrates you. That's what it comes to doing. We know that the enemy comes to steal, kill, and destroy, right? So that is the working of the enemy. Oh my God, I just thank you, Lord, for this word that I'm learning today. Hallelujah, glory be to God. So we need to learn today, saints, that our ears are connected to our heart. We need to learn today that our heart's actions are connected to our lips. We need to learn today that our lips trembling is connected to our bones. We need to learn that once that decay creeps in, our lips trembling it allows decay to enter into our bones. And a lot of us have crumbled under pressure. A lot of us have liquefied. A lot of us have disintegrated because of this thing that we didn't know. And I thank God for Habakkuk praying, and I thank God for him telling the Lord this, and I thank God for having this in the Word of God that we can see and prophetically glean from this prayer. Lord, I worship you, Lord Jesus. And then it says right here, my legs trembled. Your lips quivering at the sound causes your decay to creep into your bones when you begin to say things that's not in line with faith. And once your decay creeps into your bones, then it gets to your legs. You're no longer able to stand. Lord, I thank you for this word. You're no longer able to stand. And because you're no longer able to stand, your legs begin to tremble. And tremble means, if you just need to know, hallelujah, let me give you this word here. Hallelujah, glory be to God. I am so thankful for this word. Thank you, Lord. Through your Holy Spirit, I thank you for this word. Hallelujah. So here we see tremble means to shake slightly but uncontrollably, to shake with slight movements continuously and uncontrollably, to shake vibrant. It means to be afraid, or anxious about something. Okay, so when you begin to, the decay enters into your bones, then your legs will begin to be anxious. Your legs will no longer stand still. The Word of God says, stand still and see the salvation of our Lord. Your legs will not stand still. They will be anxious. You'll begin to want to do things very quickly. Want to do things to try to appease the sound that you're hearing. Want to do things to try to get out of the way. Want to do things to try to say, hey, I'm afraid. I need to do something to cover. You'll go back to the Garden of Eden where Adam was when they found out they were naked. Then they tried to, you know, hide themselves. This was the same process. This was the same process going on. They heard, their heart pounded, their lips quivered, the decay crept in, and then their legs trembled. Hallelujah. The five ways, you know, to fall. You know, the Lord is sending this word today. This is a prophetic word. This is not anything that I've studied. It's not anything that I'm reading from any place. This is God speaking from heaven what is going on in the church today, what is going on in the realm of Christendom, you know, that we are hearing and allowing our hearts to pound, and we're allowing our lips to quiver at things that is not God, which is changing our worship. And when it changes our worship, then decay creeps into our bones, and then our legs tremble and they don't stand still. Our legs tremble, they don't stand still, and therefore some of us fall. Some of us fall, and if we fall into sin, then that's the condemnation the devil wants to take us out anyway. So I'm telling you these five keys. Five keys. These are really five secrets, hallelujah, that we can stand against the wiles of the devil. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. That when we hear that we won't allow our heart to pound, that we will not allow our lips to quiver at the sound. We will let our lips quiver at the word of God, not at the sound. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. And then decay will not creep into our bones because we know how to guard our heart. And then our legs will not tremble. Our legs will stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. And then it says, and then he goes on and says, yet I will wait patiently for the day of calamity to come on the nation invading us. This is why I say this is a spiritual invasion, because there is a nation invading you when you're going through this. A nation is invading you. A nation is invading you when you're feeling like this, when you're going through these different things. It's a nation invading you. And I say this is the spirit of the living. It's the spirit of the devil. Satan, I rebuke you. It's the spirit of the enemy trying to do a spiritual invasion on you. And he's coming through your ear gates. And then he can take over from the ears. He did this to Eve in the garden. He spoke to her through her ear gate. Her heart began to pound when she looked at the tree and said it's good for food. Once her heart began to pound and look at the tree and said it's good for food, her lips began to quiver. Her lips began to quiver and say, has not God said? Well, he said, and then you can't think about what God said because you began worshiping this thing, the pounding of your heart. Because whether it's the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eye, or the pride of life, those are the things that the enemy uses to come and try to make our hearts pound. Hallelujah. And when she saw that the tree was good for food, her heart began to pound. She forgot about what God had told her because it was the lust of her eye. Then once the heart began to pound, then her lips began to quiver. And then once that happened, decay began to enter into her bones. And then once it began to enter, she ate. And when she ate the food, she gave her husband. And then their legs trembled. Then their legs trembled and they began to hide themselves and they no longer stand. You see, this is all God. This is all prophetic revelation. I know nothing of this. I didn't study it or anything. God is good. I give him the glory, honor, and praise. Hallelujah. Because he's revealing to me how to stand, hallelujah, against the wiles of the devil. So I give God glory for this. And he said, yet I will patiently wait. I will wait patiently for the day of calamity. There is a day of calamity coming for the nation that's invading you. There is a day of calamity coming for everyone that speak a word against you that causes you to your heart to pound. There's a day of calamity coming for the enemy, for the Satan. That there's a day of calamity coming for him. Who's trying to invade us. A day of calamity is coming. And we're going to wait patiently for the Lord. That's what God wants us to do. He said, wait patiently. We're going to wait patiently for the day. We might look like we're not winning now. You may look like you don't have a job. May look like something is going wrong. But God say, you know, we can wait patiently for the day of calamity. It's going to be all right. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. And then it goes down to the 17th verse. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. It says, though the fig tree does not bud. Now here it is. We're going through things in our life and we're talking about the fig tree not budding. There was no fig trees budding. Here it is. Okay. And he says, and there are no grapes on the vines. There are no grapes on the vines, you know, and though the olive crop fails, you know, and the fields produce no food, there are no sheep in the pen. Okay, people may leave your church. You know, you may not have money. It said there's no cattle in the stalls. You know, there's no food. There's no nothing. So right now, you may not be seeing anything. You may not be seeing anything. Everything looks dry. Everything looks like it's just at a halt right now. But he said, what I'll do. Yet will I rejoice in the Lord. That's in verse 18. He said, I'm going to rejoice in the Lord. I'm going to rejoice in God, my Savior. That's who we rejoice in. That's who we rejoice in. Hallelujah. That's who we rejoice in. So in all of this, even though all of this happens, this is our ultimate objective. God wants us to rejoice in him. He wants us to rejoice in him. He's our Savior. He said, the sovereign Lord is my strength. That is our strength. Anytime something, you know, our strength is the sovereign Lord. We can't have strength in our own self. Our strength is the sovereign Lord. Our strength is the sovereign Lord. I said, the joy of the Lord is my strength. I mean, and everything we do in life, I don't care what we have, what we don't have. Our strength is in the sovereign Lord. Our strength is in the sovereign Lord. And I just thank you, Lord, that right now I find my strength in you. I find my strength in you. He said he makes my feet like the feet of a deer. God will make your feet like the feet of a deer. Right now, it may not look like you could stand on different places or you may not ever get to different places, but God said, I'll make your feet like the feet of a deer. I'll put you on a high place that nobody can walk there but you. And I'll make your feet able to stand there. Even if it looks like the cleft of a rock, even though the deer can stand, you know, on the steepest hill. He said, I can put you on there. I can display you. You just have to put your trust in me and know that I'm your strength. He said, he enables me to go on the heights. A lot of people are afraid of heights. But God said he's going to enable you to go on heights, places that you never thought you'd go, places that you never thought you'd go. He's going to enable you to do that. He's going to enable us to do that. How? As we put our trust in him, as we put our trust in him, as we glorify him as our strength, as we rejoice in him in the name of Jesus, as we don't allow our heart to be troubled, as we don't allow our heart to pound, hallelujah, because of what we hear, hallelujah, glory be to God. We're not going to allow our heart to get discouraged, hallelujah, because of trouble. We're not going to allow our hearts to get discouraged because someone left your church. You're not going to allow your heart to get discouraged because you may not have a car, you may not have money, you may not have this. We're going to rejoice in the Lord because He is our Savior, He's our strength. You know, and right now, I don't have a car. Right now, you know, I'm sitting here, I don't even have a job. You know, but I praise the Lord right now. This morning, He gave me this word. And He's letting me know, Maxine, don't worry about it. Don't let your heart pound because of what you're hearing. Hallelujah, glory be to God. And He says, don't let your lips quiver at the sound. Don't let decay creep into your bones. And don't let your legs tremble. Wait patiently for the day of calamity, for the one that's trying to invade you. Wait for the day of calamity. Hallelujah. There's some people that's mocking and maybe saying things against you. Word of God says, wait patiently. It's the day of calamity coming for them. You need to keep rejoicing. You need to keep rejoicing. Stand. Stand. When all you've done, you need to still stand. Hallelujah. And I'm saying still stand. When I say still stand, that means nothing moving. Nothing moving. And then nothing moving. Not your mind, not your eyes, not your ears, not your mouth, not your words, not your hands, not your feet, not your spirit. Nothing. Nothing moving. You're standing still. Still standing. Still standing. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. So I just wanted to share this word with you. It's a short prophetic word, but I thank God for it. I thank God for it because it may encourage you in a way that you needed encouraging today. And so I just wanted to put it out here, and I put it out here with the song that the Lord gave me, and this is the word that the Lord gave me. If you would like to get in touch with me, if you would like for me to speak at anything that you may be having, then I would be more than happy to do that. I am the Lord's mouthpiece. He called me that. I didn't call myself that. And it's in singing or speaking. And you can visit my website at www.maxinehopkinsministries.org. And you also can email me at maxinehopkins1@gmail.com, or you can call me at 706-306-6124. Again, this has been the Voice of Prophetess Maxine Hopkins, and I hope you were blessed, edified, and...